I moved here about a year ago. I am the chair of the Department of Microbiology and Immunology. My lab has been interested for many years in developing antiviral therapeutics to treat viruses like the SARS-2 virus, but we focused on a different family. For 25 years before I moved here, I lived in central Pennsylvania. So we did not have a major medical center that performed a lot of the clinical trials. So I would say that's the primary reason that I've never really thought about engaging in clinical trials. But once I moved here, it was an option. And once I heard that they needed diversity in particular in the trial, I thought that it was something that I could do and I could help contribute to the data that's necessary to see if in my population you would see an effective response. There are two visits where you get an inoculation, and then a third visit where they do a final follow-up. They take your vital signs when you come in, get your weight, height again. Then they do a nasal swab to make sure that you're COVID negative. Then they give you the actual inoculation. It's quite easy, and everyone is very friendly. This phase of the trial is really to expand the numbers, maximize the demographics that you cover, to make sure that the response in all populations is effective. Every drug that we take has to be tested in order for us to know that it's going to work in our community. We have to step up and contribute. Otherwise, we won't necessarily have a vaccine that will have the right dose and safety for our community. We need people to participate so that we get the numbers, we get the data, so that we can roll this vaccine out to try to prevent the further spread of the virus.